Let's now look to see how this momentum reversal seasonality effect holds up against all of the major currency pairs. To do that, we just add this line to our script and loop around the pairs. On first glance, it looks very compelling indeed. There's a Sharpe ratio of 1.61 there, but this is a costless backtest and we've only got an average profit per trade of 0.8 pips there. We can visualize the equity contribution of each asset by adding the code at the top just inside the asset loop. Take this output with a tiny grain of salt. It represents the equity contribution of each asset trading the minimum lot size for each. That means that we'd expect something like the pound's contribution to be more volatile than, say, the Kiwi dollar, since one lot of GBP USD is worth more than one lot of NZD USD. Really, we should buy and sell an equivalent amount of USD to have a like-for-like comparison, but this is going to be good enough for now. Again, all of this looks very, very good, other than that profit per trade thing, which turns out to be a very important thing indeed. So let's let Zorro do a simulation of what it would look like under retail trading costs. So the code that we've got on the site that you can copy and paste, it refers to the asset list DWX FX UST, which contains realistic and slightly conservative cost assumptions for our Darwin X trading conditions. First, we comment out the following line to perform a backtest which simulates realistic trading costs. And it looks like this. As we expected, it doesn't survive contact with the real world. And here's the equity contribution by asset. So that we probably didn't expect that to, because it's taking some very, very short trades, average trade length 2 hours. So let's see if we can do better by just restricting the length of trade. You know, we're having longer trades, only entering at 11 a.m. So this is what it looks like costlessly. It's not that promising because our average profit per trade is still only 0.9 pips. So with estimated trading cost, it just doesn't look so smart. So to summarize this has been a large effect. We have a sensible rationale for the effect and very strong empirical evidence that it exists and is stable across time and across assets. So everything lines up with this, but just because something exists doesn't mean that we can exploit it in the real world. And this appears to be such a case here. Our trading costs in retail FX are just too big to overcome this. It's a big effect, but it's not big enough.